Hi everyone, my name is Patrick and this is What's New in the Edge Developer Tools for version 103. In version 103, the Welcome tool has a new design and more learning content. The color picker can sample color from the entire screen. We added two node types to the memory heap snapshots. We fixed bugs in the focus mode UI. We made the 3D view tool adapt to narrow layouts. And we fixed the close button in high contrast mode. We also shipped improvements to our VS Code extension. So let's take a look at some of the highlights. First up, the Welcome tool has a new, more modern design and improved content. You can find documentation about DevTools, as well as common tasks in the Learn section, and you can find recent updates and videos in the What's New section. Next, in the Elements tool, you can use the color picker to change CSS colors. But now, thanks to the eyedropper JavaScript API, instead of being limited to the web page only, you can sample colors from the entire screen. Next, the Memory tool makes it possible to capture memory heap snapshots, which is great for investigating memory problems and understanding how memory is allocated in your programs. And to make it easier to investigate leaks, we added two new node types, BigInt and ObjectShape, which you can use to filter your snapshots and quickly find the information you need. High contrast mode is very important to many users, and we are committed to making sure DevTools can comfortably be used in high contrast mode. In previous versions of Microsoft Edge, the close button for DevTools didn't render correctly in this mode, but in version 103 this has been fixed and the close button is displayed correctly now. Finally, in Visual Studio Code, with the Edge DevTools extension, you can now right-click on any HTML file and open it in a browser with DevTools, all within VS Code. This allows you to start tweaking and debugging your running web pages with no context switching and no complicated project setup at all. This means you can have your original code, DevTools, and the browser all side-by-side in VS Code at the same time. And that's it for what's new in Microsoft Edge DevTools with version 103. You can find more information about this as well as more Chromium project updates on our documentation website. If you have ideas or feature requests, you can join the conversation on our GitHub repository at github.com/microsoft-edge-devtools. Be sure to follow us on Twitter at @msh_dev and like and subscribe to stay tuned for what's coming next with version 104.